students
at Lake Brantley High School.
Learn together.
Test together.
To find out what happens
when some stop trying
and others start getting real.
The Real Deal, FCAT!
Hey, I'm Kirsten. I'm a sophomore at Lake Brantley High School. For me, school is always just one step towards the rest of my life. I always took advantage of all the extracurricular classes I could. When it came to the FCAT, I just sucked it up and did my best. I wasn't going to let anything get in the way of my future. Now I can take all the classes I want.
Hi, I'm Billy Bob Joe, I'm a sophomore at Lake Brantley. I plan on taking honors classes all through my high school career, but, you know, ever since FCAT, I've been taking intensive reading and math classes. Not because the FCAT's hard, but last year, I just didn't take it seriously. And when I was taking it, I was just texting on my cell phone. Not a big deal. But my teacher saw me, and she invalidated my test. And won't even let me retake it.
Hello, my name is Claire. I've always been a hardworking and determined person who believes in planning ahead. I was pretty successful in my freshman year. I passed AP Bio, AP Human Geography, and Honors Algebra. Although I was pretty confident that I would pass the FCAT, I did a brief review of my notes from English and Math, and I also tutored people who were struggling with the FCAT practice. The week before the test, I started going to bed early and eating nutritious breakfast. All this preparation really made me feel less stressed on the test.
Hi, JoJo. Now I'm in 10th grade, and last year I failed the FCAT. I didn't really care about the test. I thought it was a waste of my time. It was a big joke. And so last year I didn't even show up to class on Fridays. I needed a free day. So I missed all the FCAT practice. So the day of the test, I decided I'd just go in and take it and just sleep the rest of the time. And of course I didn't eat breakfast, so I wasn't prepared. And I started taking the test and ran out of time, so I, you know, freaked out. And now I'm in intensive reading and writing classes because I failed. The class is really boring. We do a lot of stuff I've already done, and so I really wish I would have paid more attention to the test and done better.
Hi, my name is Will, and I heard that most people think it's a standard kid to fail the FCAT. Well, I'd like you to hear that, unlike my gifted friends, I got a good night's sleep, studied, and passed with flying colors. I took the test seriously because I knew it mattered. It affected my classes next year. I realized that the test has more to do with the attitude you approach it with than your ability to take it. Just don't stress and you'll be fine.
Hey, I'm Rebecca, a sophomore at Brantley. I'm a gifted student here, and I'd say that things come pretty easily to me. Usually I can just wing everything and make all A's. I definitely don't stress over tests, especially the FCAT. So last year, instead of going to bed at a decent hour, I stayed up late and watched TV. I mean, who cares? It's just another test, and it's not like it counts for anything, right? Well, that's what I thought. So I just kind of blew it off, and I didn't set my alarm. I overslept through the whole test, so now I'm SOL. This year, I have to take a bunch of remedial classes, all just because I blew it off.
Please don't stop the music.
Go ahead, go. Making my way over to my favorite place. Go. Gotta get my body moving, shake the stress away. I wasn't looking for no
one. Look my way. Possible candidate. Hi, my name's Will. And
hi, my name's Will, and I'd like you to hear that I asked the FCAT. Dance floor, acting naughty, your hands around my waist, just lift them.